In Mad Max's post-apocalyptic world, he needs one vehicle to navigate his wasteland, the 1973 XB GT Ford Falcon, aka the Pursuit Special. In this video, we'll show you how a piece of scrap became the king of custom cars and a Hollywood icon on a shoestring budget. Then we'll reveal where the original car ended up and why now it's a contradiction on wheels. Mad Max features Mel Gibson in his early years before he was a worldwide superstar and went mad for real. He plays Mad Max Rokitansky, a vigilante who tries to control gangs who now own the highway after the collapse of society. To help control this dystopian nightmare, Max needs a rugged vehicle to clean up the streets. Enter the 1973 XB GT Ford Falcon, or rather, a heavily modified version of it that became known as the V8 Interceptor, or the last of the V8 Interceptors. But that's a mouthful, so let's keep it simple with what I think is its coolest name, the Pursuit Special. The team on the original Mad Max film knew they wanted an impressive car to feature towards the end of the movie, but they had next to no money to play with. The whole movie was made with $400,000. Even with inflation, it's not quite the $185 million Fury Road had in their bank account. In fact, when they started, the original team only had $350,000 to play with, and this included $20,000 for props and vehicles, with $5,000 to keep the cars working throughout the shoot. Needless to say, we're not talking James Cameron budgets here. He'd probably have spent the whole thing on blue makeup and still have a few unpainted noses to spare. With such a tight budget, how did the team create such an awe-inspiring vehicle? The production team needed to be very careful with money. They initially wanted a Mustang as their big money shot car, but when realizing how difficult it was going to be to modify the thing, the idea went straight in the bin. Customization was going to be a huge part of the car, so they needed a shell that was cheap for spares. This is where Aussie Fords came into play. These were cheap to purchase, but equally as cheap to tweak. Using the modest budget, the production crew got three cars for less than $20,000. First, they bagged two ex-police sedans, but the real jewel in the crown was finding a white repossessed V8 XB GT. This was a far cry from the unique black-on-black finish the car had in store, which we'll detail later. The amount they paid for this reclaimed gem would be pennies in comparison to the car's worth today, because this was the GT that would become the Pursuit Special. Imagine being the previous owner of that repossessed vehicle. You would have been devastated that your car is now worth hundreds of thousands of dollars. Then again, if they kept up their repayments, Mad Max might have been driving around in the likes of a Ford Escort instead. Speaking of likes, feel free to click the thumbs up if you're a fan of the Pursuit Special or this video. Now the crew had the basic cars, it was time to turn them into stars, especially the GT. I think the young people these days refer to this as a glow-up, or at least the car variety anyway. Customization was tasked to Ray Beckley of GraphX International. According to the company's employees, the Pursuit Special was treated just like any other car in their workshop, despite the fact they were creating one of the most iconic vehicles in movie history. As far as they were concerned, it could go back to the queue with all the other pieces of junk they were pimping. But with such a restrained budget and a workshop to run, GraphX were not exactly prioritizing this Frankenstein Ford. So how did it become the iconic Pursuit Special that we know today? And what happened to it after it went through hell in the original film? I'll let you know right after this sentence. When the work started to modify the car, the blower was the first thing to be fitted. This was mounted on top of the air cleaner and was a relatively easy job. The fiberglass nose was fitted in a workshop belonging to former Ford stylist Peter Arcadepane. And this Ford wouldn't be the last star to get cosmetic surgery. The spoilers were thanks to Errol Platt at Purvis Fiberglass Products, who described the process as relatively simple, which included a little bit of grinding and some sick effects and bog, whatever they are. Sounds like modern dance crazes to me. Truck painter Rod Smythe and his brother did the flares, and then all that was left was the paint job. So when we said this was all done on a budget, we really meant it. It sounds like the whole town had a go at doing a bit on the car as a favour. The movie's art director John Dowding had given one simple but ambiguous instruction when it came to the colour, black on black. So Ray Beckley took this as a matte black finish on top of gloss paint. He instructed Smythe to paint the car, and the result was a world away from the original white of the GT the team had picked up. What they ended up with was a mean-looking and unique finish worthy of the name the Pursuit Special. The rest is history, and the car would go on to have its own surprising history itself, which we'll cover later. The first Mad Max film at the time of release was the most profitable movie of all time. It went on to make $100 million worldwide, and remember, it was made for only $400,000. So no wonder the studio wanted to make a sequel. Hollywood isn't exactly known for not milking sequels for every cent that they can. Case in point, the Marvel Cinematic Universe. After the first film, the Pursuit Special had been put up for sale to recover over budget costs, but amazingly, no one was interested in it, so the car was given to a behind-the-scenes mechanic as compensation for unpaid work. Little did he know how the value on that set of wheels was set to explode. Or was it? With a budget of the second movie in the millions of dollars rather than the hundreds of thousands, the production team repurchased the special car from the humble mechanic and made themselves a double for stunt scenes. The double was killed off as the car itself appears to be destroyed in the film, which left the original a little battered but otherwise unscathed. While we're talking about iconic customized on-screen cars bought for a pittance, this car or the 60s Batmobile, which is your favorite? Regardless, let's get back to the Pursuit special and where it ended up. After filming the sequel, the car was put up for sale again, and even this time didn't go for an amount of money worth talking about here. It was then bought by someone else until it made its way into the hands of Bob Fosenko, when it got a full restoration and toured the globe before finding its way into the Birdwood Motor Museum in Adelaide. This was in the early 90s when Mad Max was seen as a bit of a relic. Eventually, after having the car on sale for a while, it made its way to my home country, where it was bought to take its place at the Cars of the Stars Motor Museum. Its current resting place appears to be the Orlando Auto Museum, as despite being put up for sale in 2020, it still seems to be displayed there, which must make this car one of the most wanted, yet unsellable cars in history. I can only assume that no one wants to buy it because no one wants to associate themselves with Mel Gibson. Because other than that, who wouldn't want this absolute legend of automotive movie history?